Hi guys, I have another clip that I am going to be sharing with you today. Very disturbing indeed. Very disturbing. You can see the headline that is on the screen now. I don't understand why these people don't, you see? This thing grieves me so much because these things are happening more often than we think. And these things has got to stop. Why? What kind of heart these people have now for? I mean, you see, them it's not them bloodline, you know. It is in there, a lot of their bloodlines, because it's like they're just wired to be some evil set of people. What kind of heart does a person have when they're gonna be cruel to a child? You're gonna be cruel to a child who actually cannot defend. Like, these people need some special, let me go a special place in hell, right? Let me go ahead and read what the headline is saying. A West Virginia couple is back in the media. In the media headlines after a judge revoked their bond on the charges of human trafficking. Indictment documents reportedly accuse Donald Ray Lance and Jean K. Whitefeather, both Caucasian, of NSLAVING at least 5 adopted black kids. Oh my God. 5. What's going through these people's mind? Do they think you cannot get rid of black people? It doesn't matter what you do, there is no way you can get rid of black people. And it's high time these people, them people need help. Honestly, let me go further and hear what the story is, what the headline is saying. According to the outlet, the update occurred nearly 2 weeks ago on June the 11th. Local law enforcement first arrested Donald, who is 63 years old, a 63-year-old man, and his wife is 62, in October 2023. At the time, a wellness check at their West Virginia home revealed that the couple had 2 of their adopted teenagers locked inside a shed on their property. It's like they're treating these kids as animal. Like, neither Donald nor Jean were at home when deputies first arrived. Deputies found a third black child, aged 9, inside the West Virginia couple's main home. 3 hours into their wellness check, Donald Ray Lutz arrived at home with an 11-year-old black boy. An hour after him, Jean pulled up to the house and led deputies to the last child, a 6-year-old black girl who was with acquaintances from the couple's church. You see, these people use church to get away with a lot of the things, or to hide the crimes that they are doing. They try to, they use a church to pretend as if they are somebody good when you see what they are. The 16-year-old girl reportedly told deputies the couple had her and the 14-year-old boy locked in the shed for 12 hours with no food. You want a wicked up smarter than that? Lock them in the shed, not even a dog you would treat like that. Deputies, the couple had her and the 14-year-old boy locked in the shed for 12 hours with no food. Additionally, the 14-year-old boy had open sores on his bare feet. Per court docs, the Metro News cited the teen's physical condition included body odor and an unclean look. So they're not kept no time at all. Boy, I don't understand the heart of these people who do these cruel things. Jean K. Whitefeather previously told the court the shed was a teenage clubhouse that was not locked. However, reports from the deputies painted a different picture. The shed reportedly had no running water and only an RV porta potty.
Additionally, the teen revealed that they were forced to sleep on the concrete floor with no padding or mattress. Good God Almighty, man. People can wicked, so? Can people wicked like that do this kind of wicked act? And you know, you don't have their people coming about and talking about these things. What kind of heart you have to do something like that to other human being? The indictment reportedly cited neighbors who claim that the children were forced to perform farm labor and were not permitted inside the residence. It's unclear who called the authorities for the wellness check. Thank God for whoever called the authority. So I say, and the judge revoked a couple's bond for this reason. Donald and Jean face multiple charges related to human trafficking and a minor child, use of a minor child in forced labor, and child neglect with a risk of bodily injury or death. Despite evidence and eyewitnesses account, the West Virginia couple pleaded not guilty to the charges. Them sick in a them head, because only a sick person could say they haven't done anything wrong. Authorities kept them locked up at the South Central Regional Jail. Their original bond was set at $200,000 each. They paid it in February after the sale of an 800-acre ranch in Washington for $725,000. Them have money, man. That's why the authorities make them a ghetto with these things for such a long time, because them have money a pumping at the church, so them turn a blind eye to all these things. Because me sure say people know what's going on. The church people, where she goes, they know what's going on. However, Kanawha County prosecutors argued in court that the money for their cash bonds was contraband directly or indirectly used or intended for use of violating human trafficking laws. Oh, God. Earlier this month, Kanawha County Court, Circuit Court, Judge Mary Clay Akers found merit in the prosecutor's arguments. Akers revoked their bond, calling it insufficient, and raised it to $500,000 each. Meanwhile, the Kanawha County Circuit Court Clerk's Office is holding on to the money the West Virginia couple paid in February. Judge Akers believed the money should be placed in a trust for the minor victims of the case. Rightfully so, writing out of the judge, because I mean they can't be paid for all the emotional damages, but at least the money will help them. They can probably get the proper psychological help. The indictment alleges human trafficking, human rights violation, the use of forced labor. Judge Akers said human rights violation specific to the fact that these children were targeted because of their race and they were used basically as slaves, from what the indictment alleged. The West Virginia couple are due back in court on September the 9th for their trial. I hope the judge lock up and throw away the key, because these people are a wicked bunch. They are horrible, horrible individual that does not deserve to be residing with us. Like, it's like, why all these people can't just, like... All we need is love, guys. We need to practice love. We need to treat each other as we would treat ourselves. The world would be so much a better place. It is just such a simple thing to do. It doesn't require any money. It not require nothing at all. Once there is love for everyone, the thing will just be running as smoothly as possible. But no, some people just want to hold a certain standard, the illusion that they have that they hold a certain standard, or they're better than some people or better than others. And that is just such a ridiculous notion. I don't understand how people can be hanging on to all the hatred that has been coming down their generations. Well, it's a part of the DNA, I guess. It is a part of the DNA, and they need to get rid of people like those. Anyway, guys, thanks for listening to this story. I have another interesting story coming up, which is similar to this. And this just shows you that these people, is like they have an agenda. They have an agenda. They go around all these places pretending that they're trying to help people who are less fortunate than themselves, but that is just a cover that they use to treat people in a way that they're doing. Because look at this couple now, 60 and 62 or 65, they're in their 60s, between 60 to 65, both of them, and they have that heart. Nothing hasn't changed about them. They haven't grown. Nothing about how the world is changing, they haven't changed. It's like their mindset is stuck in 1950s, 1940s. Like, what is going on? What is really going on? Anyway, guys, remember to like, share, and subscribe. This is just these stories give me a headache, honestly. I will catch you in the next clip, guys. Guys, I'd like to share this story with you. It's about an American couple who moved to East Africa in 2017, where they adopted 3 kids. They moved to Uganda and they adopted 3 kids. What I want to find out, aren't there any children homes in America? Why would you leave America, where there are so many children homes, and go all the way to Uganda to adopt 3 kids? Guys, the couple had moved to East Africa in 2017 for humanitarian work, and they adopted 3 children. They adopted the 3 kids a year later from the Welcome Ministry in Jinja City. So it's a Christian organization, so they get the kids to adopt through those kind of organizations. I tell you, I don't trust when it comes on to Christian people who say they are Christian are doing this in the sake of Christian. Nah, you can't catch me that. They said amongst the three children was a 10-year-old boy who was HIV positive and attended a special needs school. the cops and the local media, they reported. The Ugandan authorities said the Spencers constantly tortured the children starting in 2020, which attracted the attention of the attention of neighbors, some of whom took videos of the incident, the outlet reports. They leave their country and go to somebody else's country, and what I tell you about those set of people. Look at the previous story, and then there's another story. I tell you, these things happen way more than we would like to believe, right? The authorities are describing the incident. The authorities are describing it as a horrible conditions foster parents impose on the children. So the horrible condition that the children have to be living in, that's what they report it as, right? Authorities said the couple forced the boy to remain barefoot and naked throughout the day and would occasionally make him squat in an awkward position with his head facing the floor and hands spread out widely. What kind of foolish come like some prison? I tell you before, and I will tell you again, these people, they are psychologically imbalanced. Something is wrong with them mental. Their mentality is off the grid. These people are not right in the head. The child was also made to sleep on a wooden platform without any bedding or mattress and was only fed cold meals, according to police, who noted he could have endured more severe acts of torture away from the camera. The Daily Monitor cited a caregiver who told police that the child was singled out by the foster parent, who accused him of being mentally unstable, hyperactive, and stubborn. Now, who mentally unstable, Lisa? Who mentally unstable in that situation? I want to leave the job, but I know if I left without doing something about it, the torture would continue, the caregiver reportedly said. The couple have pleaded not guilty to the initial charges of aggravated torture, which carries a maximum sentence of life imprisonment. And not guilty, imagine. On Tuesday, the couple were also additionally charged with aggravated child trafficking, you know what that is, a crime which carries the DEATH penalty in Uganda, according to the state prosecutor. I hope that these people are prosecuted to the full strongest arm of the law. The arrest reports claims that Spencer recruited, transported, and kept the child via abuse of position of vulnerability for purpose of exploitation, according to the outlet. They appeared in a magistrate court on Tuesday, but were not able to make a plea on the new charges as they can only be heard by the High Court, and they were remanded to Lucia Prison, a maximum security prison. That's where they belong. That's where they belong. Court hearing has yet to be scheduled as of Thursday. The couple's attorney claims cops have no evidence and calls for a case fishing expedition. What's that? The couple's attorney attempted to defend the couple, claiming authorities had no evidence and characterized the case as a fishing expedition, the Monitor reports. Last time we were in court, the state said that inquiries are complete, and yet today they have added a new charge and said that inquiries are ongoing, she told the press. It doesn't make sense. Their lawyer had asked the court to release the Spencers on bail and cited unspecified health issues of theirs that they could not be adequately treated in prison. Them never know, so them have health. What kind of condition them have? They are 32 years old. They don't have no condition and they belong exactly there. I hope they do not give them any bail. All right. The story goes on. The bail application has been denied. Prosecutors call Coppola flight risk, rightfully so. The U.S. Embassy is monitoring the situation. However, their bail application was ultimately denied as prosecutors claimed there were no ailments that could not be treated within Uganda's prison system. Right. Meanwhile, the Spencers were also denied bail due to being a flight risk, prosecutor says, calling their likelihood to abscond from bail really, really high. Of course, they're going to run and go back to America. You can't give them no bail. They have no community or families in Uganda, and the offense with which they are charged currently is of grave nature, attracting a penalty of life imprisonment. They should get it. Like, you do the crime, you get the time. You shouldn't be complaining, you know, whether or not you have family here. That's neither here nor there. Therefore, their likelihood to abscond from bail is really, really high, the prosecutor John Kiko told the court. The U.S. Embassy in Kampala is currently monitoring the situation. Why? On Twitter, it says the Kampala Metropolitan Police managed to charge two American foster parents with aggravated torture of their 10-year-old son called Kamea John Spencer. The suspects were identified as Nicholas Spencer and his wife, Mackenzie Spencer. Guys, there is no end to what these people will do. This is a very sad story, and these things need to be highlighted so that people know the things that are taking place, you know, in the world, so that these things can be stopped. These people need to stop, not be allowed to go in other people's countries and exploit their citizens. There are enough people that are living in America, a lot of homeless people that are in America that you people should seek to help. But no, you don't want to do that, because the likelihood of you getting caught doing what you're doing in Uganda, if you should do that in America and get caught, the likelihood is very, very high that there will be some whistleblowing. You know, it's not going to be so easy. So you people choose to go to the countries that are less developed to go and commit your atrocities. Guys, when I saw this story, I just thought I had to share it. It's not the stories that we would like to hear, but nevertheless, it's what's taking place in the world. So guys, thanks for listening. Remember to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Peace.